game account and get people broadcast off some services.
Again, they'll throw with Rodgers.
YouTube.
And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left.
All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense. But in this situation, it was the hands that made the play. Batting the ball away on an attempted touchdown pass. Excellent job. Way to knock it down.
So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points.
Yeah.
From the left hash, a chip shot here. And Crosby... teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there. But this is a real, I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
I would say that if we have
frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
It's a gain of 3, and it gets him the first.
I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just 3rd and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle.
And Big Ben intercepted a 3rd time. And it's Ha-Ha Clinton Dix with a pick. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring. And Rodgers intercepted a 3rd time. A great read, and it's picked off. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. And he is going to lose yardage here. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give him a little bit of help.
Yeah, he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people, bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
Here's Roethlisberger, and that is incomplete.
If you're a defender, one of the fun things about playing zone defenses, especially in today's football, is that it's not as static as it was in the good old days, meaning you just dropped to a point and reacted to the football. Now you end up with a lot of man-to-man principles once you get into your zone defense. In other words, get to your assignment and then locate a guy coming into your area, and then you...
And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. A great read, and it's picked off. And a return across...
That's the thing you learn. I just put square. Did you see that interception I just got? Yeah, man. I thought I was like, I think this is what I meant. like, always mess up on stuff. And then, my friend, because he knows my defense is too good. So you setting it up, right?
I got some weed out in Dallas. Now I'm smelling like LA. Met it from Miami to the Machiavelli. Left the kids on the belly. Left the vid on my celly. She ate like spaghetti. I'm hitting gas and ready. Met some killers in Memphis. Fresno, hard colder than Minnesota in October. Don't interrupt, darling, I'm in the zone. Why does everywhere I go just remind me of home? You know that state of gold with the bed. Them other places come close, but they don't compare.
Now I've been to New York, come on, Texas,
yeah,
Midwest, and it all reminds me of California. Cause there's no place like California. California, A-A-T-L-M-I-A-D-M-V. All reminds me of California.
Man, I'm trying to think what they're going to be making us do at practice today. I want to run the polls again. That stuff was fun. I got to go start at 2:45 and I get back around 5 or 6. The yellow crayon. Huh, you can't go all white, but I can. Huh? Yeah. An hour or two ago. No. I told her. Yeah. Told her that's a trash. We forgot to pick up the box. Like, I didn't know that when you picked that team. I always, when I play franchise, I get him from the Titans all the time. Yeah. Man, I'm... I remember when people used to like to play franchise on here. See, now we got a whole different Madden for a lot of people on the PlayStation 5. And this is the NFL on EA Sports. No, it's going to be franchise. It's going to be franchise on 18. It's going to be franchise.
It's the Titans going up against the Packers. With that, let's get you up to Green Bay, Wisconsin.
I didn't put that in story for you in pitching. I thought you saw that.
Larry, there's just something that feels right about a snowy day for football in Wisconsin, and that's what we have here on the frozen tundra of Lambeau Field in Green Bay.
You know the weather does not affect the
game. We've got a good matchup on tap between the Tennessee Titans and the Green Bay Packers.
Okay, let's play for the end of the first quarter, and then we can play. That's why I kind of like don't like playing with other teams because you don't never know what. You think I'm in trouble? That I do what? I really don't care. I was about to say, you can see what I put in. It doesn't matter. Don't. Yeah.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Down, Mariota dancing to his left. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away.
Intercepted.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Morgan Burnett, and his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line.
Brandon, when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach and talked about how they wanted to begin this game offensively, they talked about their script, didn't they?
And I got
10 to 15
all
plays,
come on,
the first
man.
10 to 15 they had on their script. Nowhere on the script was there throwing an interception, I have to believe.
And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had possession there, but he couldn't hold on and it's second down. And if this offense is going to flow today, certainly the running back will be a key piece.
Without a doubt, because they asked their runner to not just do that, but to block, to catch, to play the tone for their offense.
To throw, it's Rodgers. He's going to try and go deep again.
Oh, that was
bad. He's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on, third down. So now an early third and 10 here on their opening drive. And here's a look at the defensive unit that hopes to halt this offense today. It's caught, Nelson. And now look at this, big gain, but a fumble. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble. And defensively, maybe an opportunity miss there.
No doubt about it. When that ball's out, you're thinking about as a defender is, this is our chance to make a huge play. Instead, he's able to recover his own fumble. And usually, big sigh of relief, huh?
Yeah, usually those wide receiver fumbles, there's open space around for the defense, but not there. He hops right back on it. Rodgers now on first down. And Nelson's got it here right side.
And the 2016 NFL Comeback Player of the Year was Jordy Nelson. He had a fantastic year after the knee injury in 2015. Well over 1,000 yards again. And once again, he was the number one target for Aaron Rodgers.
NFL high, 14 receiving touchdowns. What dimension does he add that makes them so good on offense?
Dependability as well as speed. All right, Jordy Nelson's type of guy who can run any route you want. Yet he can also take the top off of the defense, as we like to say, by running past people. It's a heck of a combination to deal with. Plus, Aaron Rodgers knows when he gets in trouble, he just looks for Jordy Nelson, and 9.9 times out of 10, he'll find a way to get open.
Nothing on that one. It'll be second down. They couldn't get anything going there out of the right side of the flat of the swing pass.
And didn't we have a discussion with their staff about wanting to get the backs more involved in the passing game? Huge emphasis for this game, but obviously.
Fighting for the end zone. He lost the football. It's out. It's picked up by the Titans.
Nothing throws. D-Sync has a character stats. That means that, I don't know. It says a D-Sync has a court. The scores and stats and quit from this game will not be on record. I know, but they still gotta say that even though. It was like Aaron Rodgers fumble. No, and it took. Crash. No place like California, California. I know that's, if I would have scored, they would have been like, all right, keep the game going. If I didn't, they would have crashed the game. I would have took my. Oh, you think you'll do that in this game? Kansas City Chiefs. Oh, yes. That's very. That'd be very, very sad. What a career. Oh no. Fresh off a flight to Boston, got a BC in Maryland that I piped too often, headed right to Austin, most likely flossing, tight exhausted, high as a forklift, handful of goons out in Colorado, any given afternoon you can catch a hollow, honestly it's the same out in Richmond, Virginia or California, either state you can get it, I done seen everywhere from Russia to Delaware, trust me I'm well aware, Barcelona to Belair, Petty to the deep fraud, I'm telling, he saw how heaven. He boss, every project, every seashore. And I ain't content trying to seek more nomadic. I probably wind up alone. All it takes is a melody to remind me of home. I've been to New York, come on, Texas, yeah, Midwest, and it all reminds me of California. California, California, A-T-L-M-I-A. I feel bad for you. MV all reminds me of California. Because I just loaded up on the thing and it says you have white jerseys. Yeah. Because I'm loaded into the game already, are you? But I won last. Wait, did I win?
I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Today's game features an old rivalry from the 2005 NFL draft class.
It's Alex Smith
going up against Aaron Rodgers.
I was playing.
With that,
I was
up to
playing.
Legendary Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin.
You already get mad. You like it.
Larry, there's just something that feels right about a snowy day for football in Wisconsin, and that's what we have here on the frozen.
It's going to be a perfect day today. Ain't going to be nothing. Just perfect. Your defense is trash. Yeah, keyword once. How many times have my team Green Bay Packers blew you out? But yeah, I'm up one, right? So cool your Jets. Nobody tapping out. I'm full blast.
On first down, Rodgers eluding the pressure right. He completes it to Jordan Nelson, and they're able to.
Welcome to my neighbor. Won't you be my neighbor? Welcome to my neighborhood.
This one across the 35.
Everything. You got what?
First down and 10 now for the offensive group.
Everything.
Throwing on first down is Rodgers. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down. And here's the offense today that hopes to get off to a strong start. Second down here after the incomplete pass. Rodgers will try again on second down. And his pass incomplete. He was looking for Ty Montgomery that time. And it's third down. And a glance now at the Chiefs' defense.
Marcus Peters is a former first-round pick who has great anticipation and tremendous ball skills.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
They do go for it. It's Rodgers. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. Smith now to throw. Screen pass to Charles. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Give him seven on the play, and it'll be second down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Here we go with Jamal Charles. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
Now Smith, and this one caught by Travis Kelce.
There are certain words that sometimes we overuse, but there's one that's really welcome on a player's resume, and that's the word breakout. And I thought Travis Kelce was one of the breakout stars of 2016 in the NFL. What a season he had with Kansas City.
Over 1,100 yards. Now, to put that into perspective with everybody else that was catching the football for them, the next closest had 593 for the Chiefs. So, breakout year indeed.
And for me, it's how he did it, because he did it in a variety of ways. Whether he's an inline tight end, a guy could split out and really become a wide receiver. And then when he caught the ball, he ran like he was a running back.
And certainly a key cog in this offensive wheel is Jeremy Maclin.
You've just got to find ways to get him the ball, whether you put him in the slot or put him out on the perimeter.
And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks. So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. Now it's the Princeton man, this is Spencer Ware. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight. And a peek at the defense for the Packers.
Ha-ha Clinton Dix attracted a lot of attention when he was about to enter the NFL for his ability to play the football in the air. He's actually shown that he can tackle pretty well in the league, too.
In a double coverage, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. So after the INT, it's Rodgers. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. It's a gain of 14 there, and it'll be a Green Bay first down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space.
Is this intercepted? It is. It's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his crew will take over. 45-yard line. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field, certainly not what they wanted.
Put it mildly, that is so frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in a good spot, great place to run some of your best offense. Instead, they turn the ball over.
They turned the ball over last time. See if they can avoid doing it here. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Now Smith, he gets a complete to Harris, and he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
How about the timing on that one? Boy, they were in sync, weren't they? Three-step drop, balls out of his hands, right to the tight end. Nice completion, just like they do it in practice.
On first and 10, Smith forced out to his left. And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20. A very solid gain of 27. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
Give him 9 on the play, and it'll be second and about a yard.
The it's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks. But doesn't matter what you call the position, it's who you put there, and there we saw completion. There are so many times during camp and practice that you get bored as a player doing regular drills. But how about that shed and skate drill right there by the linebacker? You do it each and every day.
And oh, he coughed it up, and it's complete to Kelsey. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. Very tough spot here for the offense to start. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Now after the fumble recovery, it's Rodgers. And it's hauled in by Jared Cook. A gain of six there on first. Second down now after the pass completion.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Now it's Rodgers, and Rodgers intercepted a third time. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. And they take over. They'll set up shop at the 46-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. And so close to hitting pay dirt last time, fumbling down near the goal line. Now, how does that affect their psyche this time around?
It's a tester, that's for sure, because to be that close and come away with no points is really disappointing, not just for the guys on offense, but the defensive players, too, who thought, hey, we'll put some points up and have a little momentum going. They've got to find a way to just get it out of their minds, let it go,
short-term memory,
and move on to the next series.
It's already second and 12, the defense hoping to push them back more. They come up in an empty set, four wide receivers, one tight end. Under pressure, he's going to go down. Look at this, way back around to 43.
But thanks for running the ball. It really showed me what I have to do to pick the defense to win.
Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. As the Chiefs in possession of the football as we begin the second quarter. They do, however, have a tough third and long coming up.
Yeah, it actually would. The guy I replaced was not a good person to get off a run.
And the offense now will try to regroup after the sack on second down. They come out 5 wide.
Oh, no, I'm not used to it with the freaky stuff that
third and long, it's Smith. He sets to fire deep. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because
that's
the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit, and they may have to change accordingly.
And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it.
I'm the home team.
And with the play clock at 5, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. So on fourth down, Dustin Colquitt to punt for KC. Trevor Davis deep for Green Bay. And he'll send this one into the cold Lambeau night. No returning this one. It sails out of bounds. And they'll spot it right at the 20. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. They'll come out in the pistol. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Little lull in the action here to go over an offseason storyline. It's kind of interesting. L.A. a couple years ago, they have no teams, and now they're going to have 2 with the move from San Diego to L.A. What does that mean for the league and for the Chargers?
It seems like an easier transition, doesn't it, than St. Louis when they moved back to Los Angeles?
Less culture shock.
Less culture shock, less, you know, obviously geography, the whole deal. But it's a transition is not going to be easy. Remember, they're going to go play in a soccer stadium, essentially, at least the first couple of years. years before they share a stadium with the Rams. So that changes things. Obviously, trying to create an identity in the market they haven't been in a long time. They began as the Los Angeles Chargers, but only played one season as such.
Yeah, so if I was going deep, I'd probably get downfield.
The rookie fifth rounder Tyreek Hill back deep for Kansas City.
Oh, you better look at him.
And that one hits at the 7, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. And out come the Chiefs now. And 3 and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul searching now.
I would say so.
I was trying to aim out of bounds, but the wind came out of hours. The ball still further down the field.
That's the old adage. When you get another chance, it gives you a better chance to do it right.
They'll start the drive with Jamal Charles. He'll get about 3 as he's taken down at the 23. The tackle will be credited to Jake Ryan.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player. But you know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. And he is finally out of bounds, but not before taking it down inside the 30. A big play there for KC. 48 yards. First down, it's Smith. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. Just a 1 yard pickup on the play, and that'll make it a second down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
I was not basketball person.
On second down, here's Smith. Steps away to his left. And he's got room and avoids the contact by sliding. A nice pickup there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
And the play clock about to expire. Andy Reid notices it and takes a timeout. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Now a play fake here on first down.
Ooh.
To his left, Travis Kelce, the Pro Bowl tight end, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down.
A pretty rocky start in this game for the guy throwing the ball. Already he's throwing one interception. Almost threw a second one right there. All he's doing right now is giving the defense a whole lot of confidence.
Back to the air, Smith on second down. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. He'll get a couple yards on that one. And that's going to lead to a third down.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the next step in utilizing this position is to actually utilize more of a scat back in this spot. Because we saw the catch there, right? He made it. He's a bigger, stronger guy. Maybe not quite as elusive as maybe someone else you would put
in. Yeah, didn't get the big yardage there. You might have a smaller back.
Just looking at it from a defensive perspective, when you break the huddle in the red zone, tight end is one of the guys you've got a key on because quarterbacks want the ball in their hands fast in this position, and they want to get it to someone. And in this case, he had the play. They just didn't complete it.
So an empty possession, then what do you think went wrong, Charles?
Well, it looked like maybe the plant leg might have given way just a little. And when that happens, guys have a tendency to pull through the ball to compensate. And in doing so, set this one off target.
And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. A minute 57 to go in this first half. We're back to Lambeau following these words. Throwing is Rodgers. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
They're going to hurry back to the line now.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Rodgers now on first down. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet inbounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Got a man, and he hits him in stride. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. And the offense moving quickly to the line. They go play action here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Jay Howard in there to drop him for a loss on the play. They've been moving the ball well offensively, really getting into a groove. Last play, pass completion. Now, finally, the defense gets there.
And you have to find a way to disrupt their rhythm. Do you do it with coverage, or do you do it with pressure? They elected to go with pressure, and it was the right call.
A couple of years ago, Cobb signed that four-year, $40 million deal. Since then, the numbers have been down a little bit, although last year only played 13 games.
Yeah, and I wouldn't be as concerned with the numbers dropping if I were a Packers fan, because remember, Davante Adams has developed as a player, and his numbers have gone up. You got Jordy Nelson back to full health in 2016. He's going to catch a lot of passes, almost caught 100 in that season. Jared Cook at tight end. That's a new weapon Green Bay didn't have for a while. And don't forget, Randall Cobb spent some time as a running back when all the injuries hit the backfield. So his versatility is still a major plus for Green Bay.
That's caught at the 3. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. And the D looking like they may blitz. Defense may be thinking pass. They come out in the nickel on 3rd and goal. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
So they kick it through to take the lead. There is a little bit of time left, though, here in the second quarter.
And while they're concerned about not giving up a big return or giving up points themselves going into the half, how good do they feel, though, putting points on the board themselves right near the end of the first half?
Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to.
And now the Packers going to take another timeout. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. They'll come up now in the Wildcat package. Now a direct snap. It's Jamal Charles. And he'll take this one up close to the 25-yard line. So, and Larry apparently very brief in his report. Thanks anyway, my man, as we're already set for action. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. Tyreek Hill on the return. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number 3. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. 1 yard officially on the pickup, and it'll leave them with a 3rd and 11.
And now they're in the hurry up.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt. Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
Now let's see how the offense still out there. They elect to go on 4th and 11. They're going to go for it. It's Smith being chased out left. And this is incomplete. A surprising move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And the Packers are going to get the football back in excellent field position. On first down, Rodgers buying time to his left. 13 yards there on the pickup. And that leads to a Green Bay first. And they're going to hurry back to the line now.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
And quickly, they get to the line. Rodgers going to try and throw him, and he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Devontae Adams. From 3 yards out, and the Packers add 6 to their lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't trying to chase him.
And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. And the Chiefs now getting set to go. And last time out, went for it on 4th down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do and the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on 4th down, it caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for it. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
No gain that time, but it leaves them with 3rd and 11 coming up.
No gain on that run. And while this team is down, they're not out of it by any stretch of the imagination. Maybe you just have to think about a different style of running in order to get this guy going.
Play fake for Charles. Now Smith. He's going to go deep for Conley. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. Chris Conley, the intended receiver. And it's 4th down.
Well, they decided to air it out a little bit on that play, take a shot downfield, but the coverage was really nice. Able to get a hand in and tip it away.
I'm going to receive it. No, I'm not. Yes, I am.
And he'll go ahead and field at the 5. Call that one an even 60 yards, 6-0. And the Packer drive will start from deep in their own territory with a 1st and 10. Back near the goal line, here's Rodgers. The left side throw complete to Adams. It'll be a gain of 6, and it's a 2nd down. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
On 2nd down, here's Rodgers. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Looked like a pretty good, safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy out in the flat.
Yeah, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down, a nice, safe throw and a good one.
Now Rodgers. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 6 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second down. And they're going to speed things up here. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. And again, it's Rodgers. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Here's Rodgers, and that is incomplete. For pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build.
And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Dangerous wide receiver, a 20-yard touchdown, and the Packers add on to their lead. He's got it, and it's 17-0. Now after the touchdown. Turn here. He'll make it back only to the 10-yard line. The Chiefs offense now making their way back onto the field. And still no points on the scoreboard. You're coming off of the three and out. They're just looking for anything to grab onto right now, aren't they?
I'm wondering if someone's going to take charge in the huddle. You know, we always look to the quarterback, but sometimes it's another player on the team, a star, a veteran, someone with some excitement and energy. Things happen. And be well executed, but all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Play action. It's Smith. McConley's got it over the middle, and he's brought down after a good game. And in this weather, and I know you weren't a quarterback, you were on the defensive side of things, but how hard is it to throw that football?
It can't be easy because you never know how the moisture is going to affect things, and each quarterback handles it differently. Some of them are a little bit better than others. Depends whether they wear a glove, not wear a glove, how cold is it, you know, all those things go into it. But it goes to everything else. Keeping your footing when you're running routes. Supposedly you have the advantages of the receiver because you know where you're going, but that's not easy as well.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Mike Daniels in there to get him for what will be a loss of 13 yards. Now a play fake, and it's Smith. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
And they're going to at least line up to go for it here on fourth down. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. Throwing is Smith. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. Trying to get it to Thomas, and it's intercepted. And it's Ha-Ha Clinton Dix with a pick. And his guys are going to have the football back as the third quarter comes to an end. Now the defense definitely showing blitz here. So after the INT, it's Rodgers. And it's knocked away and incomplete. Randall Cobb, the intended receiver.
Was open.
And now
okay.
It's second down.
I'm not just saying.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion. And both sides trying to get to the football. And you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team. I think the defenders have to feel pretty good. Even though the ball was tipped in the air and could have become a big play for the offense, they actually won one because the guy flinging it today, he's having quite the performance. A couple of touchdown passes, almost threw his first interception, but he's throwing it so well that I think Lady Luck was on his side.
No, it's just
on now is Mason Crosby, who's hit from as far as 58 in his career. And this will be spotted on the other side of the field. It's a 61-yard attempt. And that will line up just short. He had it online and ran out of gas at the end. And this score will stay right where it is.
Well, he's got a big leg. And when everything comes together, he can certainly hit from long range. But this one's going to come up just a little bit short. A very good effort, though.
Screen pass to Charles. A good pick up there on first as the screen pass gets him eight.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. On second down, Jamal Charles. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. They get six on the pick up there as the drive will continue.
Not too many more ideal situations at second and two in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
So it'll be first down here after the run.
We got three, fellas.
On first and ten, Smith. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. His throw incomplete.
Looks like somebody
guys are called the first screen fullbacks, the linebackers. You know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
Back to throw, Smith. He's going to air one out. Got a man, it's caught at the 6-yard line. Give him 30 yards there. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. They run it. It's Charles. And he is in. Touchdown.
They stopped
Kansas
that. Since Madden.
Jamal Charles taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Chiefs are able to cut into this lead. And there you go. Nothing really too complex. Block, keep your assignments, let them run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football. Good blocking, beats good tackling on that play. End result, touchdown.
And this one's going to be covered up by the Packers' hands team. Oh, for a second there, I had flashbacks to a few years ago, the NFC Championship game for the Packers, but here they're able to hold on.
And many things changed in Green Bay after that game. Personnel, people coaching, the whole deal. And in this case, they get it done. no fail like they had in Seattle.
Give them 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn them a fresh set of downs. They're going to hurry back to the line now. And defensively, they just don't seem to have much of an answer for this passing game.
Not at all. Look at the confidence that's exhibited here. With that type of a lead, clock on their side, instead of running it, they're still throwing it, trying to pick up first downs and keeping the football.
Another pistol look here. Now Rodgers throwing on second down. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs. And the offense moving quickly to the line. On first and 10, here's Rodgers. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. And some changes here as the D-line separates
some.
Here's Rodgers. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. It'll be a gain of 8 yards. And they're going to have a third down.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
Fighting his safety valve here. That's complete. The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, and being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half. And tough starting field position here. Three receivers to the left, one to the right. They go play action here on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested and often physical. Sometimes that leads to drops.
Back to the air. Smith on second down. And his throw here is incomplete. Albert Wilson, the intended receiver there. And it's third down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
Throwing on third down, Smith. Dancing to his left. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
It's not like pressure will affect the accuracy and the timing of a guy trying to throw the football. And on that play, they ended up flushing him to his left, contacted him as he's trying to throw the football, and that led to the incompletion.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Desperation time for Smith on fourth down. Rolling to his left. Now he'll let it go on the run. Deep left side. The Chiefs tried it, but they're turned away on fourth down. And now, boy, the ball is going to go over on downs here inside the 10-yard line. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. Rodgers now to throw. Forced out to... And they will score. It's a Packer touchdown.
Did you just really quit? Did you just quit? Hold up. Am I dreaming? Hello? 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 Anybody here? That loss is kinda sick, was it? Hello? Dukes? Call it Dukes? What happened there, Dukes? What happened, Dukes? Why you quit, bro? So? He said it. I didn't feel like doing all that. Oh my gosh, I'm so chill, bro.
Get my homeboy.